So our next presenter is Johan Cruijffert, and if you missed the introduction and Johan's background, I'm just going to share a brief intro. Johan's background is that he's the co-chair of the Open Footprint Forum, along with the IT CTO for Shell, and is accountable for defining and dividing the future IT strategy for Shell. In addition, he maintains an active link with external parties and in particular startups. Johan is based in The Hague. And Johan, you're going to be reviewing how the various, how to get used, how OFP for that matter can be used by the various industries. And I believe that you're going to share some examples.
Well, I might not have examples. I'm going to talk about very much. So thanks so much, by the way, Heidi. I'm going to very much talk about a couple of observations. Some of the points have already been made over the last 2 days. So a message to Sammy. Sam, I only need about 15 minutes, so you have to be on earlier to be ready for that. Okay, let me go to my first slide. Yeah, let's talk about the top-down approach, and it was well represented today by Jack, of course, and in his presentation around the Lord is doing and how we the COP presence later this year. We start with Open Footprint. Okay, how do we get bottom up? The standards in place, how do we define the standards? And you've seen this afternoon with the demo with Ash and with Geert Willem and with Boopy, and you saw that whole thing coming together, you saw that whole bottom-up story. So we'll soon have an MP1 coming out the door and an MP2 come out the door. But of course, now we see, okay, we have this, how do we now get this implemented into the industry? And that's why we kicked off a project called Project 4 about 6 weeks ago. I started talking to parts, okay, how can they help us with really getting that top-down approach moving, that people say, okay, we need this, we want to start implementing this. And Deloitte is an important partner over there. And therefore, the work Jack talked about this afternoon, the work we're going to do, the paper and the interviews, etc. So, and we're looking for more of these type of opportunities, and it's all about now to say, okay, the people realize that this is happening, they realize there's a need out for this, and realize that they can start using it. Therefore, also work with people like WBCSD, you heard Anne about it yesterday, another party which we want to closely work with, because you also had the link to the 30 large companies again, on how to deploy these standards. So these links to bodies and governments and Deloitte, etc., are all important again to come to and faster and acceptance into the market as well. If in the room you have any other ideas where we should be, if you've been here for the last 2 days, you've heard where we are, you heard what we're doing. If you think, hey, there's not a body out there, there's not a government out there, there's not a whatever out there, this will be very relevant to help you with a deployment, a business really acceptance in the market, deployment in the market, then please reach out, because we do need that as well. The other one is around the whole reference implementation. You could have said, of course, why do you bother about a reference implementation? Why don't you just say, let's just create a reference architecture, put in a document, put on a website somewhere, and then run away from it, and say you've done the work. You have a reference architecture, and people can use it, implement it, and it will be okay. The lessons we've learned that if you just do that, the acceptance will be very, very low. But it is too hard for people to make it to work. Therefore, like we have at OCU, also at Open Footprint, we really selected to go for a real implementation. And Geert Willem has spoken about it, Boob has spoken about it, Sam has spoken about it. The ultimate goal of all of this, not to meet with MP1, that you can download an Open Footprint implementation from the Open Group GitLab environment. And you can install it then or run it and load it then, find a simple to use script on your any of your cloud platforms, your IBM environment, your Google environment, your Microsoft environment, your Amazon environment, and over time also other environments. And really to load a threshold for people to make use of these capabilities. And that's the only way that people start making use of it. And you avoid lots and lots of problems or questions that people do things in the wrong way, that you implement the data model in the wrong way, you implement something else in the wrong way. So the whole world acceptance is also much and much supported by having clear reference implementation you can use, and over time you can also using as a proper operational environment. Not only come out with FP1, but over time we'll move to that world as well. So that's the reason we did that. It's all about how to improve acceptance in the market, how to make it much and much easier to use, and just say here you got some standards and run away from it. Our deliverable is an operational, and over time, an operational capability you can use in your own environment to do your open footprint data platform activities. And the other one, also to get acceptance in the market easier, is really we spoke about it yesterday morning. Open footprint inside. There's an important element to get open footprint outside its own comfort zone, because at the moment, of course, we're focusing at open footprint as something as a separate environment. But of course, our ultimate goal is that open footprint, because over time, what was happening, that if you have your business application with business data, that your GHG data will be part of that, that your ESG data will be part of that. So that data becomes far more integrated with your normal business data, because it is business data, not so, but it's part of your business data. Yeah. And therefore, our aim is very much and also making sure that we can easily integrate the GHG data, the open footprint data model we have today, in other environments. And any environment, don't really care what environment it is, any environment who wants to exploit open footprint in their environment, we're very keen to make that happen for acceptance into the market again. And also because in the day it is part of your business environment. And the second part, of course, also we spoke very much today, yesterday today, about GHG, the greenhouse gases, scope 1, scope 2, and scope 3. Some people also spoke about the non-GHG, because it's very important that the open footprint at the end of the day has to cover your GHG environment and your non-GHG environment. So we want to make sure that, again, for acceptance in the market, that we cover both environments. We started clearly with GHG, but we also continue with the non-GHG space. And then some other activities is the whole story around making sure that you have clear audit trails, you have clear auditing, accounting what you've been doing out there. So that's just things which are not in place with MP1. We've kicked off a project as part of MP2, and I would say MP3 in the end of the day, most likely, where we also have fully integrated accounting environment, because we need that. We need accounting fully integrated. We need the audit trail fully integrated. We need the login fully integrated. It's all part of your having reference. We know how to go back to things and have a clear audit trail of what's been happening in our environment. So accounting is not yet part of MP1, is not yet part of MP2, will be part of MP3. We have a sub-team just being kicked off in the hurry to make that happen. So that's really the main things I wanted to talk about. This, so the thing behind all of this, how do you get acceptance in a market easy up? But at the end of the day, we can spend a lot of time and effort on creating lots of standards, lots of stuff. It's not being accepted in the market. We failed. So the success is only there when it's accepted in the market. And therefore, we increasingly need to focus at that. And therefore, the help of Deloitte and other parties out there to help us with that is much much appreciated. So if you have other ideas how to get accepted in the market better, but all other things we need to do to lower thresholds, to make things easier, then do get back to us on that. So I'll leave it with that, because I don't want to go through a lengthy presentation at the end of 2 days. Questions? I'm not sure there was any questions out here. Mute myself. I don't think any questions there. Are there any questions for people? And if people don't have questions, but people have thoughts around how to what other things we can do, get back to us. don't sit there and don't say anything, because we can only learn, we can only improve if we hear from you what else we need to do or can do. Still, I don't think any questions, Heidi. Yeah, if I don't see, at least I don't see them.
No, I'm seeing. Nope, not at the moment.
No, it's so a lot. It's too. Yes. It's too long days for people. So.
It's too long days. Yeah. It's a lot of content to yeah. process, and yeah.
So let's hand over then to. I hand over back to you, Heidi. My apologies.
Okay, wonderful, and thank you, Johan, for sharing that last minute information with us, which again, it's critical to know that we're always going to be expanding. We're also, you know, going to be evolving and adding the accounting, as you say. So it's organically going to transition into different areas. So wonderful.